Now, let's bring you back here at home. It is confirmed. Ontario's stay-at-home order extended an extra 2 weeks, but the premier is still not budging as more health officials call on the province to reopen more outdoor activities.
I talk to my buddies. I know what happens. You know, they pick up another buddy, two or three, they go out, go golf, and then there's nothing wrong with golfing. The problem is the mobility. Then after golf, they go back, they have a few pops. That's the problem.
Is that the problem? Let's get reaction right now from the director of Ontario's COVID-19 science table, Dr. Peter Juni. Good morning, and thank you for joining.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
I wanted to play that clip specifically because that is what a lot of people are saying. Really, is that the case, that Ontarians can't be held with that responsibility and be able to do things safely outdoors? You have been very outspoken saying that things can be done safely outdoors. So your reaction yesterday when the premier said those restrictions are not going to be lifted?
Oh, look, I was very glad that the restrictions were prolonged in terms of restricting indoor spaces. This was excellent, no? And now it's a matter of how risk-averse you are regarding outdoor spaces and how much you acknowledge that people actually need, you know, to do something and how much you just realize that places outdoors are much safer. The point now is places outdoors are safer, perhaps 20 times safer, but we can't let go of precautions. The issue is, of course, the premier is right, if we then have, places open where people can indoors and, you know, have a beer or something together, this shouldn't happen. So what needs to happen in these situations, we need to have structural measures in place, meaning the clubhouse is closed, the locker rooms are closed, etc. And we would need clear-cut communication. What I was glad about really was that the premier said the first step we're doing is we just loosen restrictions outdoors, and he didn't mention indoors, which is a great sign. This wasn't always the case, remember that. Mm-hmm. And that's the most important distinction. Indoors is unsafe right now. We have far too many cases. Outdoors can be kept safe. Would I have opened outdoors a bit earlier? Yes, I would. But, you know, I'm perhaps a bit less risk averse than other people. And most of my colleagues, or I think all of my colleagues at the science table would agree on my attitude there. But we're on the right track, and that's important too. You know, it's impending now, 2 weeks from now, I would hope really mm-hmm. that we see more outdoor activity.
Dr. Juni, let's talk about that track that we are on. Everyone wants to know what the goal is. We've heard Dr. David Williams say that 1,000 per day case mark, that's sort of the unofficial number that they're looking at before these restrictions yes. get lifted. Can you break that down a bit further and how likely we are to hit that within a 2 week time frame?
Yes. So again, I think we need to distinguish between loosening restrictions outdoors or indoors. If we talk about loosening restrictions indoors, we really need to be far below this 1,000 mark. Why? Because we need to make sure that the testing and tracing system is not overwhelmed anymore. If you want to keep a wildfire under control, you actually need to have enough firefighters. And that's the point. You only have enough firefighters when you don't have case numbers that are too high. So we should make it, before we loosen any indoor restrictions, safely below 800. For outdoors, it's different. And I would hope and I would feel that it's absolutely justifiable now in a first step. I don't know when, a week from now, 2 weeks from now, hopefully not longer than that, to open outdoors, just like, you know, what we talked about before, you know, baseball, basketball, beach volleyball, all of that. And this can be done safely if you're just closer than 2 meters from each other. You just need to wear a mask consistently.
Dr. Juni, we have 30 seconds left, but I want to get your take on this. When we do have some sort of reopening, do you anticipate it's going to look like a color-coded framework, like we've seen prior?
Oh, I believe they would probably do something like that again. I'm not sure. What I feel is very important just to have very simple messaging. Very simple. Mm-hmm. Indoors is unsafe. Outdoors can be made safe. Follow simple rules and you're good.
Messaging. Very key as we look at all of this throughout the pandemic. Dr. Peter Juni, appreciate your time and expertise. Thank you for that.
Thanks for having me.